Well, howdy there, pluckers. I've a sore fingers again with you. Thanks indeed for joining me for another guitar lesson. This one, I hope, will be an interesting lesson for you all. It's a classic song from the Moody Blues called Gypsy. Standard tuning, no capos, doing it in the same key that the Moody Blues originally recorded the song in. Okay. So without more to do, I'm going to basically go through about two-thirds of the song, which includes all the parts of the song you need to play the whole thing. Break it down, show you how I did it, and you should be good to go. I'm just basically omitting the last verse, okay? Singing as usual will be for reference purposes only. Okay, so let's get to it. But the rest, you've got everything you need in there, okay, as far as I can see. Okay, so let's get to it. The introduction starts off with this bass sort of riff, if you want to call it a riff. Right, so we start off with a basic bottom E string open, and then we play the second fret of the A string. Okay, then we fret, however you wish to do it, the fifth fret of the bottom E string and the fifth string, the A string. Sixth string, fifth string, okay, on the fifth fret. So it's. Got that? So sixth string open, second string, fifth string, second fret. Fifth fret of the sixth string and the fifth string. And then you go up to the seventh fret and play the fifth string and the sixth string again, or the sixth string first. Fifth string on the seventh fret, so it's got that, and you can actually, if you want, slide from that fifth fret up to the seventh fret if you like. So it's, I tend to do that, but you don't have to, you can just play it straight if you want. Okay, then we hit the bottom E string on its own, okay, followed by a slide, so it's. So you hit that 7th fret of the A string and slide it up to the 9th fret. So it's so bottom E string, then slide the 7th fret of the 5th string up to the 9th fret. And then pluck the your fret, the 7th fret of the 4th string, the D string. So far we've got this. start slowly for you again. And then we do take that finger down to the 5th fret on the 4th string, the D string. 2 hits on that one. 1, then go down to the 4th fret on the D string. So far we've got this then. And then finally you play an open 4th string. And then you repeat the whole thing. Okay, got that? So slow motion. Normal speed. Okay, got that? So you play that twice, or the whole thing twice if you want, how many times you want really. And then it sort of does the same thing but with chords in it. And that's basically E minor, D back to E minor. Okay? So it's just to start with, it's ba, 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 ba. Right, so I just concentrate on the chords to start with. So it's E minor, single strum, D single strum, back to E minor, and then there's a couple of extra strums on E minor at that point. Okay, so it goes ba, ba, ba. So just do two, probably. And then what you do is you slide from the 2nd fret of the D string, the 4th string, up to the 4th fret of the D string, okay? So it's. And then go to the 2nd fret, so 2nd fret of the 3rd string, the G string. Okay, so it's. Then 2 G strings open. 3rd string open twice. So. Sorry, I can do that again, sorry. Okay, got that? And then we do a 4th fret on the D string, the 4th string. And then open D string, 4th string. So you've got this whole thing. So that last phrase is. Okay, so it's. I'll slow that right down for you. Do that sequence twice, okay? So let's go from the beginning to that point, okay? It gets easier after that. Okay, so here we go. I'll play it a little bit slower than it is normally, okay? We've got, okay, then we get to the chord sequence, the build-up chord sequence, E minor, and this is, you can do downstrokes, or if you like, just, or you can strum away, whichever you fancy, okay, mixture of the two, okay, so anyway, the chords are E minor, a form of G, so it's a G, it's like a G bar chord. Okay, 3rd fret G bar chord, but you don't. Your first finger is only fretting the 6th string. There's no bar. Okay, so those fingers are like you had a bar on, but the bar is gone, and you're just using this first finger, the bottom E string on the third fret. Top two strings, one strings, the top E string and the B string are open. Okay? So it's E minor, then this sort of partial G chord, and then up to an A, same thing again, just the top E string and the B string are open. So you're just using this finger to fret the fifth fret of the bottom E string. And then up to the 8th fret for a partial C chord. Again, same thing, this finger's just doing the 6th string, bottom E string, on the 8th fret. And the top E and the B string are open. Okay, so it's... And do that again, twice. Everything is twice. The intro, bass riff, guitar, guitar riff, then the chord riff, that's twice, and then this is twice, okay? So 2-2-2, okay? So let's go from the beginning, slowly, okay? I'll get good at this by the time I finish this. Got, and then we go into the verse, which is fairly straightforward. It's quite quick, but it's quite simple. E minor, gypsy and the strange, it changes quite quickly. It's E minor to G, however you wish to play it. So that straightforward G, or that G shape, whichever G you want to play it, okay? G, E minor, G, and then an A, straightforward A chord. So it's gypsy of a strange and distant time. Okay? Da 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 da. Okay, that's quite quick, that change from E minor to G, okay? It's a gypsy of a strange and distant time. Travelling in panic of directions blind. Aching at the warmth of the burning setting sun. Freezing at the emptiness of where it comes from. Okay, got that? It's just E minor, G, A, four times. Okay, so let's do the whole thing up to that point. That's slightly slower than normal. Okay, so here we go. We go back to the E minor for the O's bit. Oh, 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 C. Oh, 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 oh. Got that? So it's E minor. Oh, oh, C. Oh, oh. If you can play a four-fingered C, that'd be good. Then you get the bass. Get a nice bass bit as well. So that's a C chord. If you're used to playing a normal straightforward C, simple C, just move that third finger up to the third fret of the 6th string and put the pinky underneath on the third fret of the 5th string, the A string. Okay, you must get a much bassier sound, okay? So C with G in the bass. Okay. So, oh, 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 oh. Last line is E minor, left without a D, hope of coming, A minor, hope. And there's a little riff. Okay, so when you hit that, as soon as you hit that A minor, you, so I'm gonna left without a home, so E minor, left without a D, home of coming, A minor, home. So you strum the A minor, then immediately lift that first finger off and play the open second string. Then play the second on the third. So open third, fourth fret of the fourth string, second fret of the fourth string, the D string, open fourth string, third fret of the fifth string. So it's to an E minor, and it's the old that bit, that bit again. Okay, the chord riff. Okay, so we do that chord riff twice, and then we go back into the chord sequence again, building up to the E minor, G, A, and C bit. Okay, so coming out of that, the first verse, without a hope of coming home. Two of those, and then we're back to the riff. Two more riff, the chord sequence. Sorry, the chord sequence. So two of those E minor D riffs, and then into the build-up E minor bit to the G to the A to the C. Do that twice, and then we go into the next verse. Okay, so let's just go from the O bit. So it's oh, on the first verse. Second verse. So you'll see the second verse and is exactly the same to play as the first verse, okay, and it finishes the same way, the E minor to the C, oh, da, and E minor to D to A minor, little riff, but this time it doesn't do that bap, 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 okay, it goes, just sits on the E minor and sort of mute, semi-mute, palm mute, the bottom fifth string, sixth string and fourth string, sort of just rest your little edge of your hand there near the bridge somewhere, just rest it lightly on the thicker strings and just chunk it for a bit. Then it goes to the C and it does a oh, D, oh, and then back to the E minor riff. Does that twice, and then it does the chord build-up bit again for two times, and it does. Then it goes into the last verse, and then you come out of that, and you can just do that bit and finish it however you wish. Do the build-up, and just finish on an E minor at the end of the build-up or something, you know. So I would suggest something like that. So you're coming out of the. Do the second verse, which is exactly the same to play as the first verse, different words. Just go from the second verse of the OOO bits, okay? Oh, oh, oh. pass first. Tipsy of a strange and distant town, traveling in panic of direction blind. Feeling the warmth of the burning sun, scraping the emptiness of where they come from. There you have it. You have all the parts of that song, hopefully, to play the song. Thanks very much for watching this, and hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.